In this video, I'm going to show you exactly how much money it costs to start a business online. I'm going to show you the exact list of tools and resources and essentially stuff you need to spend money on in the beginning stages of your business, as well as exactly how much each of them is going to cost you so that you can plan ahead and know exactly how much you will need to invest or save to get your business off the ground. Now, I don't know if you know this about me, but my name is Natalia and I run a six-figure marketing agency where I get to work with some of the most interesting and profitable businesses in this digital era. I work with service providers such as marketing agencies, freelancers, and stuff like that. I get to work with coaches and consultants, with digital course and product creators, with affiliate marketers, as well as drop shipping people. And throughout working with all of those types of entrepreneurs, I've noticed that all of them, without exception, have a few different costs that they have to spend, take money on, and invest in their business in advance before they can start generating income. And I've compiled this entire list here for you today for us to go through one at a time. Now, before I get into the list, you should know that this list compiles of four different categories. This is money that you spend on your website, which is your main income driver. It's your main salesperson. Money that you spend on client management if you are in the services business, or if you're a coach or consultant, money that you spend on your digital course creation, content creation, membership site, in case you are one of the people that want to become thought leaders and essentially sell what you know to other people, as well as money that you spend on stuff that are day-to-day for your business, such as accounting and legals and support and stuff like that. Now, what I'm gonna do for you is I'm going to dive into my computer and pull out this sheet here, where I essentially combined all of the list of all of the things that you have to spend money on, including a full estimate of how much each of them is going to cost, as well as the total of how much you can expect to spend in the first year of your business. You can actually download that list completely for free by going to natalieray.com/business-cost. Simply opt into the landing page there and you're going to get that list completely for free right now, including the links and everything that you need to know. But with that being said, what I'm going to do right now is I'm simply going to dive into my computer and walk you through each and every one of those costs according to the four categories we've talked about. We're going to mention which company and which tool I actually chose for you to recommend to you when you're first getting started and why, as well as exactly how much it's going to cost. So let's dive in. So the first area that we're going to discuss is spending money on your website, right? Your website is your number one salesperson. It's the machine behind the scenes in which you essentially send all of the traffic that you work so hard to generate through content, through paid ad and stuff like that. Your website is the thing that will turn that traffic, those people, this audience into money. And there are several things that you need to spend money on in order to get that website online. The first thing you need to spend money on is your hosting service. And hosting is essentially the service that you pay money for to make sure that your website is actually online and accessible for other people. So it's super, super important to choose the right host, because I can assure you, the second that you're going to run into your first tech problem, which is just around the corner, I can promise you that you will need a good hosting service with impeccable support to help you push through this, right? Because you're just getting started. You're probably on your own in your business right now. Your hosting are your team, are your developers, are the people that you're going to address to in order to help you out with anything, any technical problem that might arise in your website. Now, the hosting service that I recommend to most of my clients, especially if they're just getting started, is called SiteGround. And you can check them out in natalieray.com/hosting. And when you're going to go into that link, you will notice that you have three different packages. If you're just getting started, obviously, simply go for the startup package, which costs around $4 a month. If you're going to run that into an annual cost, it will cost you around $50 a month to spend on hosting. Now, then the next thing you want to spend money on is your domain. And your domain is essentially the name, the address of your website. For myself, it's natalieray.com. What is it going to be for you? Now, for the domain, you have two different options. The first option, which is the one I recommend, is to actually purchase your domain straight from your host, straight from SiteGround. And the reason why I say that is because it will actually save you time in setting it up and connecting your domain to your host, right? And this will cost you, through SiteGround, approximately $20 while you're on the path of signing up to the hosting. They will simply offer you a domain as an upsell. I recommend you to go for it. A different option that you have when it comes to purchasing a domain, which is cheaper, is to choose a different service like Namecheap or GoDaddy, which will cost you approximately $5 to $15 for a domain. But again, you will need to figure out exactly how to set that domain up through something called DNS changing. I believe I have a video about that on my website. So if you choose to go that route, you can actually set it up through the video on my website. I'm gonna search it and actually link it in the description below so that you will have it. But my recommendation is, don't think about saving $15 here or $20 here. Simply go for the domain inside SiteGround and call it a day so that we can move on as fast as we can. Now, the next tool that you will need in order to get your website online is called a website builder. And for that, I actually have good news for you, because I will always recommend WordPress, which is a website building platform, to be your website builder. And WordPress is 100% free to use, and you can install it in just one click through the SiteGround interface. Meaning the second that you're gonna open your account in SiteGround, they will provide you an option. Hey, I just noticed you have this domain. Would you like to install WordPress on it? You're just gonna click a button and they're gonna do all this for you completely for free. So that's that for WordPress. Now, unfortunately, using WordPress alone will not be enough for you to create that beautiful and that converting and income optimized website that you have in your mind. For that, you will need an additional extension, what we like to call either a page builder or a theme. Now, there are a bunch of these on the market. Some of them are free, some of them are paid, some of them are well overpriced. I will only recommend one for you, and I use that one whether I work with a solopreneur who is just getting started, or I have seven-figure clients who work with this tool as well. And that tool is called Thrive Themes. And the reason why I recommend that one and not anything else like Elementor or anything like that is because Thrive Themes will allow you to do two things: to build any kind of gorgeous website that you have in your mind, as well as optimize that website to make you money, right? Most of the themes and most of the website platforms out there that allow you to build websites, for example, such as Squarespace, will help you build a pretty website, but that website is not optimized to generate income for you. And what use is that, right? So instead, I recommend you go to notario.com/theme and simply get Thrive Themes today. Their main product is called Thrive Suite. And what this will allow you to do is to access all of their full set of features and products that you can put on your website in order to do anything that you can possibly imagine. Some of the things that Thrive Themes will allow you to do is to build a beautiful blog, beautiful funnels, landing pages, to have leads optimized pages so that people actually get into your email list so that you can make more money, build quizzes, manage your comments, build membership sites, create scarcity timers, and more and more and more. Anything that you might need, you have inside a Thrive Suite. And this is what I use for myself, for all of my businesses, all of my websites, as well as for my clients. So highly recommended. Thrive Themes costs around $230 per the year. So it's obviously one of the largest costs and one of the biggest investments you will make for your business, but it's totally worth it. And when you think about it, it's only like $20 a month for the entire course of Thrive Themes. Now, the next thing you will need in order for your website to generate money for you is to have an account with a payment processor. This is essentially a software that allows you to charge money from other people and pull it into your bank account. Now, there are two different softwares that I like to use. The first one is PayPal and the other one is Stripe, right? And the good news is that both of these are actually completely free to use. So all you need to do is to go to the links inside this document. For the first one, paypal.com/business. For the second one, stripe.com. Simply open a free account and you're good to go. But the next thing you will most likely have, but I'm gonna put that one as optional, is a shopping cart. And what a shopping cart allows you to do is it allows you to essentially create beautiful and highly optimized checkout pages so that when someone comes to buy your product, your service, or whatever it is, they'll be able to see this beautifully optimized checkout page with some upsells in it to kind of like maximize your income. And the tool that allows me to do all of that is actually called Thrive Cart. And unlike the name, they have no relationship to Thrive Themes, unfortunately, but they're both awesome. I don't know, maybe it's something about the name. Now, Thrive Cart is something that I give you as optional because you don't have to have a shopping cart in order to start generating money. You can just send them to your PayPal link or whatever it is. But I will recommend you to have it because it's the best money that will come right back to you so fast you will not even imagine. Now, the best thing about Thrive Cart is that they have multiple competitors on the market that get super, super expensive. Most shopping carts will actually cost you around $100 per month. But the great thing about Thrive Cart is that they actually cost only for a one-time payment for a lifetime And I believe they charge around $500 or so. Yeah, $495 for the entire lifetime of your business. This is the best money that I've ever spent. I think I got this product about 4 years ago for when it was only like $300, and it just paid for itself within the first month of me actually purchasing it. So I will not hesitate. I will just pull out the money and buy it as soon as I can before they're gonna get rid of their for life option, right? You can check it out in atayoya.com/checkout. Cool. Now, the next tool that you will need for your website is an email marketing software in order to allow you to build your list and to email that list so that you can maximize your income. Now, there are two types of email marketing service that I'm going to propose to you here. Now, the first service that I'm going to recommend you here is called AWeber. And this is an incredibly efficient email service. And the best part about them is they will actually allow you to use their services completely for free for up to about 500 subscribers. The bad news, though, is that at some point your business will outgrow AWeber and you will have to upgrade to a different service. And in that case, it's kind of a headache to do because moving your email marketing, moving all your automations and all of the stuff that you actually already built there is kind of a headache. So my recommendation is for you to actually get going in advance with the email marketing service that will allow you to scale to whatever size of business that you want to go to. And that email service that I recommend, I use for myself as well as for all my clients, is called ActiveCampaign. And what's cool about ActiveCampaign is that even though it's super powerful, it's not expensive, such as Kartra or other services that are out there. And it will only cost you around $69 for up to 500 subscribers, which will be approximately $100 for your first year in business. So that's my recommendation here. Now, the last kind of tool that you will need in order to get your website online and make sure that it's beautiful and that it makes you proud is a graphic design tool, which allows you to create all the designs and all the different elements that you need for your website. I personally use a service called Canva, which is again, completely free to use. They do have upgrade options. I use their pro version, which is paid, but you can simply go to natayoya.com/Canva and sign up for the free account because it will allow you to do most of the things that you need for your website. So overall, if you're going to add all of these costs for your website, it's going to cost you anywhere between $400 to $895 to set up your website and to get it online as quickly as you can. That's for the website. Now let's move on to the second area of business that you will need to spend money on, possibly. It's called your client management. And this is where you're a coach, you're a service provider, maybe you're a consultant, and you have all kinds of different clients coming to you that you need to manage them on a day-to-day basis. So the very first thing that you will need is to conduct meetings with those clients. And I conduct almost all of my meetings using a free software called Zoom, which is again completely free to use. You can check it out in atayoya.com/Zoom. You probably know that software. Another software that I like to use is called Google Hangouts. And again, it's completely free to use. So don't even bother to spend money on this right here because when you're just getting started, you actually don't need the premium versions of any of those softwares. Simply go for the free one. Next one you want to use is a meeting booking platform, which will allow your clients to book a meeting with you without doing all of the back and forth in email. How is that time? Oh, I'm busy at that time. How is that time? Oh, I'm busy at that time too. You will simply be able to send clients into a specific link where they will be able to choose the time that you want to meet with you. So again, here I use a free tool called Calendly, which does have free options as well, but you can get started with it completely for free. Now, for the last tool for your client management is all about day-to-day interactions. Sometimes client needs stuff from me immediately. Sometimes they need to let me know about something. Sometimes they just need to consult to someone. So they send me like a voice note. And I use three different free softwares here. The first one that I use is Slack, which is a completely free, kind of like a workspace chatting software. The second one that I use is WhatsApp, which I use on my phone, which will allow me to send voice notes and videos and to conduct actually video meetings or whatever I need, again, for free with my clients. And the last one, especially if you are in the US, I know that many American people like Voxer, which is a different version of WhatsApp. But regardless what you're going to choose, all of these applications are completely for free. Simply go to your app store, and for Slack, simply visit slack.com. So the total cost of your client management up until now will be completely free to use. Now let's move on to the next section of your business, which is your content creation, your courses, and your membership. So in order to generate all of the content that you needed, the courses that you needed to actually make it online and set up and beautiful and ready to go, you will need several tools as well. The first tool that you will need is a platform to actually create your courses for you, meaning you just finish shooting a course. What are you gonna do with this now? How do you put it online? Now there are many different tools out there, but for me, if you're just getting started and you wanna save a little bit of money, but still use a platform that is super powerful and allow you to create anything, I will just use Thrive Themes again. And the best news is that it's already free to use because you've already paid it once you sign up for it on your website. And Thrive Themes will allow you to create membership sites, course websites, all kinds of things that are gorgeous and the clients will love to use. And all of this is accessible to you and free to use when you sign up for your Thrive Themes account in atayra.com/theme. Now, the next thing that you will need is to actually shoot videos and edit them, right? Like I'm doing right now, maybe do a screencasting like I'm doing right now where you see my screen and me as like a little person at the side of the screen. And for this, I actually use a software called Filmora, which is super, super cool, easy to use. It will also allow you to create all kinds of cool effects. And Filmora actually costs only about $90 for a lifetime account. So I would propose you to buy a lifetime because I believe the annual one costs like $80. So I would just spend money on the lifetime account and that's pretty much it. You can check it out in atayra.com/filmora. Now, the next thing you will need is to actually shoot videos like I'm doing right now. And I know that many people use fancy schmancy cameras that cost like $2,000 or whatever. Dude, I just use my phone. Like, I think that regardless of what kind of phone you're using, the quality will be good enough for YouTube, for content, for courses, especially if you're just getting started. And the best news about this is that it's completely free to use. Now, the next thing you will need is a microphone. Now, there are several cool microphones that you can use that might be kind of pricey. For example, I use this one, the blue snowboard thingy, whatever. But to be perfectly honest, you're just getting started. You don't need to spend a lot of money on fancy tech. So instead, I would just invest in a cool lapel microphone, which costs around $40 on Amazon and has a really, really good quality for the price that you're paying. So this is my recommendation here. It costs around, again, $40. And then the last thing that you will need is something to allow you to create slides and graphics for your courses, right? And again, here, I just use Canva, which is, again, completely free to use, making the total investment that you will need to invest for content creation, membership site, et cetera, only about $130. Now, let's move on to the last section that you will need to spend money on in your business. How much money does it cost to run your businesses day to day? And in here, you have several different things. The first thing that you want to do for your business is actually get yourself legalized, incorporate your business. And for here, I actually used a company called Zen Business, which helped me set up my American LLC, even though, by the way, I'm not an American citizen, nor am I an American resident, but they helped me out with all of the stuff that I needed. And Zen Business, in order to get your business set up, cost me around $150 lifetime cost. And after that, one thing that you will need in order to get your business and to make sure that it continues running, only if you live in the US, by the way, is called a registered agent. And for that, I also use Zen Business for that and it cost me around $100 for the whole year. Now, the next thing that you want to use is an accounting software, something that allows you to track your income, your expenses, and all of that so that by the end of the year, you can submit your taxes hassle-free. For this, I actually use a free software called Wave. And again, it's completely free, but they also have a cool upgrade that I'm using as well. They actually have a plan that's, I can't remember how it's called, but it's essentially where you get a personal accountant to help you with your business. I actually upgraded to that option, which cost me around $180 or $200 per month for me to not have to worry about anything accounting in my business. So that's one option, or you can do it completely for free using all of their trainings out there on the website and enjoy that while you still can afford a full-time accountant for you, right? Now, the next thing that you will need is a banking service. And even though I know that most people are tempted to use the bank that they have for their personal accounts, for me, when I run my business, I want a bank that understands digital businesses. I want to be able to log into my bank from any kind of app. I want to be able to interact with them, no matter where I am in the world, what time zone I am in the world. I don't want to have to come to any kind of banking establishment physically in order to conduct my business. I want to be able to do all of that digitally because I just don't have the time. So to do that, I have two different banks that are specifically working with digital businesses. You can open an account no matter where you are in the world and enjoy all of the benefits, all of the services, a business card, anything that you might need. So the first bank that I'm going to recommend to you in case you are opening your business in America is called Mercury, and they are the bank that I'm using for my American business, and they are completely free to use. Now, if you run your business from Europe or from other parts in the world, I would actually recommend a different service called Wise, and I use them for my Estonian business. I have a business in Europe as well, and they're as well free to use. Now, the next thing that you will need is a project management tool, and this is the thing that essentially allows you to remain accountable and to know exactly what are you doing. When are you doing this? What exactly are the steps to get this to happen? If you have a VA or a small team, it will help you to work with them way more effectively than if you were to have like a to-do list on your notepad or whatever. And for this, I use another free project management tool called Asana. Again, it's free to use. I upgraded to the actual pro version of this just because there are some things that I need for my business. But when you first get started, Asana is perfect for you and will allow you to learn how to conduct yourself as a true business owner and be super, super productive while doing that. Now, the last tool that I'm going to propose to you is a tool to do customer support, right? The more your business grows, the more that you will notice that there are a bunch of different things that you have to manage at the same time. People will send you messages through WhatsApp, through email, through your Facebook page, through your Instagram DMs, through your Twitter, through comments on your Facebook page. Like, there are so many different places that you will need to talk to people, and you will waste so much time doing that. So instead, what I like to do is I like to gather all of those things into one place, into one tool where I can do all of my customer support in one place. Well, I don't actually do it on my own. I have a VA, but if you're just getting started, it will allow you to save a bunch of time from going to Facebook, then replying to comments there, then going to a Twitter and replying to comments there. You'll have everything, including the email, all in one place. Now, to do that, I have actually a couple of tools to recommend to you. The first tool is called Freshdesk, and it will allow you to simply do basic email support completely and 100% for free. Or if you want to, again, have a tool that essentially compiles all the different things for all of your social media and stuff, I actually use a tool called Trengo, which costs me around $15 a month, which is essentially about $180 a year, right? Yep. And if you're going to combine all of these costs together, it's going to cost you anywhere between $250 a year all the way to $430 a year. Now, once we have all of these costs for all the different areas that you need in your business, I want to kind of like give you the total. And the total of everything we've talked about, if you're going to go for all of the free routes that we are discussing here, it's going to cost you around $780 for the year to run your business like a pro when you're first getting started. Or if you're going to go for all of the premium versions that I personally recommend, it's only going to cost you around $1,455 for, again, the entire year. So this is exactly how much money it costs to run your business online. About $400 to $895 for your website, free for your client management, around $130 for your content and course creation, as well as $250 to $430 for your day-to-day, which will summarize and around $780 up until $455. This is exactly how much money it costs to run your business online. Now, let me know below which one of those costs that you like most, which one do you actually plan on spending money on, and which one did you say that just like, it's just not for me right now. I'm just going to go for the free route. I'm going to not do this part of the business just yet and simply focus on the important stuff like my website or whatever. Let me know in a comment below. I'm curious to know. And if you want to download all of the sheets that we've just gone through with all of the numbers, all of the links and everything that you need, simply go to natayaray.com/business-cost and download it there for free. And if you're interested to learn more about exactly how to start and grow your own freedom-based digital business, if you want to learn exactly how to do effective marketing for that business, it comes from the heart, it doesn't make you feel like a sleazeball, and if you want to learn exactly how to manage that business effectively and efficiently to feel like a boss without that business taking over your life, make sure to hit the subscribe button right here below this video and hit the bell as well to be notified about any new video that I release about a video every single week. I'm gonna see you in the next video. Until then, yalla bye.